Hi friends, welcome back to the new series Angular Interview Concepts with Explanation. In this series, I'm trying to explain some of the concepts those are most focused on Angular interviews. If you just prepare for your Angular interview like a question and answer format, it won't help you a lot. If the same question is asked differently, you may struggle. Instead, if you understand the core concept behind that, you will not forget forever and you can easily answer. That is what I'm trying to explain with some examples. Let's start. We know Bootstrap is the most popular HTML and CSS framework for building responsive layouts with ease and without having a deep knowledge of CSS. In most of the Angular applications, developers prefer to use Bootstrap. There are multiple ways we can add Bootstrap to an Angular application. In Angular interviews, interviewer may ask different questions on this topic. How to install Bootstrap in Angular? What are the different ways we can install Bootstrap? Is it good to use Bootstrap CDN in Angular, etc. In this video, I'm going to explain about the different ways we can follow to use Bootstrap in Angular applications. Also, pros and cons of those approaches. Let's start. I have created an Angular application and started the server. Let me delete everything in app component and add a container div. Inside that, I'm adding a button with Bootstrap classes, btn and btn success. As I have not added Bootstrap yet, we will not see any Bootstrap styles. Let's add Bootstrap. First, let's try the CDN approach. In index.html, we can add the Bootstrap CSS from CDN server. And so we can see the Bootstrap styles got applied. The advantages of this approach is, this is very simple and also we get all the advantages of CDN like cache hit, geographically close, etc. But following are the disadvantages. If the CDN server is down, our entire application will be collapsed. Also, the team who is maintaining the CSS in CDN may often deploy new code, so there may be possibility of introduction to vulnerabilities in our application. So the security team will not prefer this approach. Let me comment this and move to the next approach. NPM approach is the choice of most of the developers. We can use the command npm install bootstrap to install bootstrap. After installing bootstrap locally in our application, we can either mention in index.html or in our styles.css directly or in angular.json. Previously, we were able to use it in index.html, but nowadays when I use it in index.html, I'm getting this MIME type error for some reason. So let me import this in styles.css. So now we can see the Bootstrap styles are reflected. But instead of importing in styles.css, mentioning in the styles array of angular.json is the classical way. When we mention in angular.json, we need to restart the dev server. Only then it will reflect. This is the preferred approach. The main disadvantage of this approach is most of the components in Bootstrap depend on jQuery. So if we need to use any Bootstrap component like model, dropdown, etc., we need jQuery. So installing Bootstrap alone won't help. Installing jQuery in Angular is not advisable because it is better to avoid using libraries that make direct manipulation of DOM. Angular should handle that. Considering this, let's look into another approach. Before that, let me uninstall this Bootstrap package and remove it from angular.json and also restarting my server once. We have npm packages like ng-bootstrap, ngx-bootstrap, etc. We can install one of these packages to add Bootstrap. These packages implement the functionality in Angular way instead of jQuery. And some of these kind of packages has schematic support too. So it is very easy to add and we don't want to restart the server. Let me use this command to add Bootstrap. We can see it has updated the required files also, including app module and styles.css. Now we can see Bootstrap styles are reflected. So I will say this is the best approach. If you have a different opinion or if you are following a different approach, please mention that in the comment section. Also, please subscribe to my channel and support me. I'll be back with a different concept soon. Thank you. Bye.